dear brothers and sisters, dear everyone. These days, everyone in the world is talking about what? Is talking about coronavirus. They are talking about measures to stop it, measures to protect themselves from it. Some countries banned people from traveling to other countries. Many countries banned other people to come to their places. Everyone is wearing a mask. Everyone is talking about it and so on. Subhanallah, big debate. The whole world is shocked because of this coronavirus. Now, there is something missing in all of this. What is that? Where is Allah Jalla wa Ala in all of this? Who caused this? Who can protect ourselves from it? What is the real cure? No one is mentioning anything about Allah Jalla wa Ala. And Allah Jalla wa Ala is the one who created everything. Allah Jalla wa Ala says, Allahu khaliqu kulli shay. Allah Jalla wa Ala malikul mulk. He controls everything. Allah Jalla wa Ala says in the Quran, وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُ. No one knows the soldiers of Allah Jalla wa Ala except himself. Allah Jalla wa Ala sent punishment on other people by ants, by different created beings. This could be a punishment from Allah Jalla wa Ala. It could be a punishment from Allah Jalla wa Ala. It could be a reminder from Allah Jalla wa Ala. It could be a mercy from Allah Jalla wa Ala, because Allah Jalla wa Ala wants us to remember him and to go back to him. The whole debate is being secularized. There is no place for the religion of Islam in this discussion. Subhanallah, Allah Jalla wa Ala mentioned few verses that will solve this debate. First of all, Allah Jalla wa Ala says, قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا هُوَ مَوْلَانَا وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. This verse is more than sufficient. So nothing happened without the will of Allah Jalla wa Ala. The second question is, why is these things are happening? See, my dear respected brothers and sisters, there are calamities that befall individuals and there are calamities that befall societies. The calamities that befall societies, normally they happen because Allah Jalla wa Ala wants those people to go back to him, to repent to him. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala says, فَلَوْلَا إِذْ جَاءَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا تَضَرَّعُوا. Hadn't they humbled themselves before Allah Jalla wa Ala when they sees the calamities befalling them? Why didn't they do that? وَلَكِنْ قَسَدْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. But their hearts became hardened and they did not repent to Allah Jalla wa Ala. We see everywhere, we see injustice taking place everywhere. We see injustice against our brothers and sisters in China, in India, in Syria, in many other places. And the world is not doing anything regarding that, especially certain countries that exercising in more injustice against our brothers and sisters. Allah Jalla wa Ala is causing this to happen so people might repent to Allah Jalla wa Ala and think of him and stop these sins. ظهر الفساد في البر والبحر بما كسبت أيدي الناس. This is happening because of what people have earned, what they have done. The last thing, my dear respected brothers and sisters, apart from putting our trust on Allah Jalla wa Ala and having tawakkul on Alayh, we need to make our dhikr. Our dhikr is the real protection. Before we are talking about medicine and our other measures to protect ourselves, we need to talk about dhikr of Allah Jalla wa Ala. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told us that in the morning and in the evening there are certain dhikr that will protect us from everything. When we go to bed, there is a dhikr. When we leave the house, there is a dhikr. There is a dhikr for cure. There is a dhikr for protection. Learn those adhkar. Allah Jalla wa Ala will protect us. It is the main protection after tawakkul of Allah Jalla wa Ala. May Allah Jalla wa Ala protect us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
All I'm trying to do is to encourage you, inshallah, to encourage you to say, let's do something about it.